So, quick thing that just came up recently. I was asked to explain what are the ways to increase lead quality. And so there are five ways that you can increase lead quality. And so this is if you were like, man, my leads are weak, or I want my leads to be higher quality, or people are complaining to you, or whatever, right? There's five ways to do this. Now, that being said, the monetization structure behind it, you're going to want to play with these variables so that you can optimize your throughput so you can get the most amount of sales or most amount of cash up front, depending on whatever it is that you're optimizing for. All right. So it's not to say that you should do all five of these things, because sometimes you are going to be leaving a lot of money on the table, because ultimately you want to remove as few of these, or sorry, as many of these as you can, because they're all bottlenecks on the amount of volume you're going to get. And so each of these will increase quality, but typically decrease volume. And so these are the trade-offs that you'll do in the marketing side. These are the variables that you'll play with in order to get the optimal setup for sales. All right. So without further ado, the five ways that you can increase lead quality. Number one, your targeting. All right. So the targeting, you can do this in a couple ways. One is you can just do it by zip code. Other, you can do it by income level or profession. Those are all things that you can do to immediately increase lead quality. If you go to only the rich zip codes, you're going to have higher quality leads in general. Right. That being said, if you're doing those zip codes, just understand that other people are also marketing those zip codes, and they will probably also be more expensive, and your volume will be lower. So there's number one, is the targeting, right? Number two is the number of steps that they have to jump through, right? If someone has to do 10 steps in order to get on the phone with you versus one step, they're going to be more qualified because they took more action, so they're more in pain, and they're more likely to want to work with you, right? Or they were more compelled by the offer headlines, etc. So that will increase the lead quality as well. Number three, excuse me, is the nature of the offer. All right, so a free offer versus a paid offer, or a free amazing giveaway, compared to a click here to schedule a sales call, is going to create a very different type of prospect, right? Not all leads are created equal. And so, if you are having someone opt in for a giveaway, you will have more volume by a ton. And so that's where there's so much emphasis on the monetization structure behind it, and the mousetrap that you've built. In order to, like, if you have a giveaway, I know plenty of people in the industry that do giveaways and crush it because they have a good mousetrap behind it and they take advantage of the volume. But if you don't do a giveaway and you do a straight to call, then that person is going to be more qualified than somebody who is opting in for just like a giveaway or whatever, right? The fourth is going to be an application, right? So if you have application is sort of the same thing as adding a step, but it's different enough that I figured it was worth mentioning. So you can have like four pages in a row that only require one checkbox. Or you can have one page that has a lot of questions on it, right? And the nature of the application, if you have lots of paragraph question answers, it's going to be more work and therefore a higher quality lead compared to lots of check boxes and ABC, right, type questions and answers for the application. So that's another thing that you can do to implement to increase the quality of the leads that are coming through. Simply adding an application before they have access to you will increase the quality of the lead. And you can also, there's a lot of psychology behind the questions that you're asking the application. So getting them to state their goal, getting them to state that they have a problem, getting to understand what their biggest unknowns are and the things that they're struggling with, understanding that, setting the precedent that there is going to be an expense. Are they willing to invest in, in a solution for their problem? And if you want to and have big balls, which I would encourage you to do, put some sort of minimum amount. If your thing's, let's say your thing's $1,000, say, hey, are you willing to spend at least $500 on the thing? It doesn't mean it has to be that. But at least it gets them in the ballpark around where you're going to be, right? And then finally, the fifth thing that you can do to increase the quality of the leads is provide value first. All right, so this is going to be the actual content of the advertisement itself and the video itself. So if you have a video that's incredibly compelling, but doesn't necessarily explain anything or add value to the consumer, then you might get lots of leads, but the quality might not as be as high. Versus a video that might be 5 minutes long and provides a tremendous amount of value, tactical importance that they can immediately implement in their lives, then that person might be more qualified if they come in because they're like, this person has already provided me value. I already know that they're good at what they do. And so it gives you a more authoritative positioning in the prospect's mind so that they will be more likely to give you money. All right, so there's lots of ways to increase quality of the lead. The trade-off and where you have to come in as a business owner, not just a marketer, is understanding how your business model works behind it. My two cents on this is that I try and start with the biggest, widest net as possible and then work backwards. And so what I mean is I just want to get flow. Once I get flow, then I'm going to try and create a series of offers and upsells on that flow. that will allow me to make more money on the customer, because the worst thing in the world is not having any flow to begin with. And so I would rather start with a much wider net and then create a series of offers and indoctrination sequences and pre-frames that after I get the flow, we'll get someone to give us more money. And typically, if you are good about your sales engineering and choreography behind the opt-in, behind the application, behind the call, that's the model itself, then you should know what your numbers are on, let's say, a free trial or somebody who downloads a lead magnet or whatever it may be. You should know that for every $1 I put in here, at day 15, I'm at $1. At day 30, I'm at $3.50. At day 60, I'm at $7. If you don't have those numbers, it will be much more difficult to make decisions about your marketing without that. And so all that being said, the time to use these five increasing in quality type applications is when you have so much volume and the quality of the prospects is so low that you are willing to sacrifice half the throughput or a third of the throughput on the advertising to either get a higher ticket or to accommodate for your operational capacity, right? If I can get, let's say I'm booking some sort of national campaign and I'm going straight to call, if my team can't handle as many and I don't mind doubling my lead cost to put a fence up because I can't even handle the flow that's coming in, then in that instance, it would be worth it for me to double my lead costs because it doesn't matter as much to me and I can't handle the operational flow. But for me personally, I tend to start with the biggest net and then try and see what I can do on the back end to put the onus or the responsibility on the model and the monetization structures and the sales sequence so that I can afford whatever I want and then ultimately have a high volume, high ticket sale or mid ticket sale type business. And we've rinsed and repeat that exact same model in brick and mortar for the gym. We've done it for the supplement company. We've done it for gym launch. We've done it for now the online fitness model that we are getting all of our, you know, seven figure gym owners to walk away from and go into because they're simply making more money. They're able to get the same average price point on these clients as they were before, except they're able to get an unlimited lead flow and the average, the cost per lead is about a fifth, right? And so as long as we can make the machine behind it work, which took us three or four iterations to get it really tweaked and we continue to do so, put the onus on the model rather than on the marketing and typically you'll make more money. That's just been my personal experience and I hopefully that provides value for you. So otherwise, hope you have an amazing Thursday. I hope that gave you five different ways you can increase lead quality if you need it. For many times though, you just need to look behind the lead at the monetization system that they're coming into to make sure that you can afford the traffic rather than trying to tweak the front end. So maybe it was giving you an answer without giving you an answer or giving you the five things, even though you might not actually need that. It's usually the model itself. But if you do have an issue of having too much traffic and the people aren't qualified and you're willing to increase how much you pay per show or you don't have the operational capacity, then adding one, two, three, four, five of these qualifiers in is an easy and fast and reliable way to increase the quality of the leads coming in. So otherwise, have an amazing day, and I'll catch you guys on the flip side.